After learning about my connection to the herd of Algidi, you contacted them for more information on my studies. They invited you to visit New Orleans, where they promised to share the results of their research. During an otherwise cordial meal, the members of the herd of Algidi began discussing comets and strange rituals associated with their passage. Your suspicions arose too late. Outnumbered, you soon became captives of the herd of Algidi. My poor friend. I'm dreadfully sorry that investigating my death brought you to such a dire end. How can you possibly escape this predicament?
We'll be back for you. You can count on it.
You did it! Now that you're free, you should take this chance to escape the mansion.
I can't leave without my friend.
Yes, of course. You must find your friend first.
We've got this one locked up in the kitchen pantry. Andrew took the other one to the servant's bedroom.
I bet he'll forget the key in the living room again.
Probably. If so, that'll be another corpse to get rid of.
They appear to be discussing your friend.
Those sound like footsteps upstairs.
Every minute you remain here is another chance they'll recapture you. Save yourself.
Who are you? I can see you aren't with this so-called herd.
This man is an intruder. He shouldn't be here.
You must have caused that commotion that drew them away. What a lucky break.
Who are you?
Rex Murphy, ace reporter. Too much? Yeah, too much. Anyway, I write for the Arkham Advertiser.
What is a journalist from Arkham doing so far from home?
What brings you all the way to Louisiana?
I picked up a lead on a wild story. Local Arkham lady claimed her next-door neighbor was using a voodoo doll to torment her. Some dispute about a cat using a flower bed as its litter box. I know this voodoo talk sounds crazy, but she had pinpricks all over her body. Anyway, doll seller was one Alphonse Lanouis from right here in New Orleans. He says he sold only an ordinary doll, so the angry neighbor could work out his frustration without harm.
I've heard of Alphonse Lanouis. What led you here to the mansion?
Even though Lanouis swears he didn't put any voodoo on the doll, maybe somebody else did. A group called the Herd of Algidi are supposed to have a book full of evil secrets. That sounded like headline material, so I came to have a look around. Looks like I kicked a hornet's nest.
That's so crazy, I believe it. I'm trying to find my friend so we can get out of here.
Help me find this voodoo book, and I'll help you look for your friend. Deal?
What a fortuitous encounter. Now, to find your companion and escape.
I wouldn't mind a glance at this book myself. The Herd of Algidi might be a cult, but it appears they were also scientists.
Never mind the book. It's your own skin you should be protecting.
You know, there's something odd about this sky globe, or whatever you call it. We should check it out.
The door's locked, but I don't see a keyhole.
Thank you. Did you hear that? Something clicked.
That didn't come from the globe. It's from the corridor. Did we do something?
You really should reconsider this pattern of breaking into people's houses and breaking their things.
What is this beast?
What science could create such a beast? It looks most like a goat, but its eyes radiate an almost human intelligence.
Why is this beast locked up in here? Is it a prisoner? Considering all those symbols, maybe they worship the thing.
I bet it's guarding something important. Could be the book. We'd better get rid of it.
If it is a guardian, it must be powerful. Run, my friends. Run while you still can.
This painting seems familiar.
It is certainly a striking image.
I know. It's the same as the one at Professor Tillinghast's home.
Oh, of course. I have one just like it.
The professor sent inquiries to the herd about their research. Perhaps she also shared a copy of the painting. There you are. The door's locked. Judging by the plate, I need a brass key.
Nothing in life is easy, is it?
Let's get you out of there.
Now all we need is to find this evil book.
What is this beast?
What science could create such a beast? It looks most like a goat, but its eyes radiate an almost human intelligence.
Why is this beast locked up in here? Is it a prisoner? Considering all those symbols, maybe they worship the thing.
I bet it's guarding something important. Could be the book. We'd better get rid of it.
If it is a guardian, it must be powerful. Run, my friends. Run while you still...
Thank you.
It's down.
I wouldn't be too sure of that. If that creature is as supernatural as those symbols indicate, you may have no way of killing it. Flee for your lives.
Let's hurry up and find that book, or whatever it was gotten.
Yeah.
Did the bookcase move?
It sure did. And there's a door behind it. I bet my typewriter that's where we'll find the book.
Let's have a look. Hiding so many books in an attic library can mean only one thing. They must be full of occult lore.
So much ancient knowledge gathered in one place. Imagine what I could have achieved with such resources.
If I were a book of evil magic, this is just where I'd call home.
This place feels eerie.
Here it is. Le Cult des Ghouls. Looks like it's all in French.
The illustrator of this book has witnessed the supernatural firsthand. We too have seen some of these monstrosities recently.
This pattern looks like a constellation. It's Capricornus, the one we keep seeing.
There'll be time to read after we get out of this mansion.
Uh-oh. We have company.
Thank you.
Was having this book really worth all the trouble it caused you?
We have the book and everyone's here. It's time to move.
His name may pop up more than once, but I can't imagine this Alphonse Lanoui will prove helpful to your investigation. If you insist on seeking him out, you can find his shop in the French Quarter. You're wasting time pursuing this Lanoui character. He's untrustworthy at best, an outright liar at worst. If nothing else, New Orleans is a beautiful city to visit. You never know what you'll find around the next corner. Of course, not everything one finds here is a pleasant surprise. I hope nothing tragic befalls you on these unfamiliar streets.
Finally, we're in the French Quarter, and there's Jackson Square up ahead. If Rex was telling us the truth, we'll find Alphonse Lanoui's shop on a back street nearby.
I still think this Lanoui is not to be trusted.
Shop. This must be the place.
The door's locked. Mr. Lanoui, we've come to talk to you.
Hey, get away from my shop. Hey, you won't trick me that easily, you bloody-handed assassins.
What? We're not.
I warned you he's untrustworthy.
Mr. Lanoui, we're just here to talk.
Leave it once before I call the police.
He sounds upset. Maybe one of his neighbors can help us talk to him.
The Those men are attacking that woman!
Let's give her a hand.
Thanks for your help. I don't know what would have happened if you hadn't come along when you did.
You're welcome. Who are those men?
I've never seen them before. They cornered me just as I came out of the social club. Maybe they heard me singing there. I haven't seen you before either. What brings you to the French Quarter?
We need to talk to Alphonse Lanuit at his voodoo shop, but he seems reluctant to let us inside.
Mr. Lanuit? He was friends with my late grandmère. He might remember me.
We'd be delighted to have you, but things aren't always safe around us lately.
Oh, don't worry about me. I can hold my own. Just not when outnumbered 3-1.
I don't know whether you can trust this local guide you've discovered. But let's hope your good deed in saving her goes unpunished.
All we need to do is show Lanui this sign. That sounds too easy.
Let's give it a try.
Mr. Lanui?
I told you to go away. Ah, so you're requesting sanctuary. Very well. If Aristide vouches for you, you may come inside. Now that I have a closer look at you, I must say you don't appear very much like assassins. What do you want?
Assassins? Such a manifestation of paranoia is often a sign of a disturbed mind.
All I can say is that someone out there wants to kill me, and I won't take one step outside my house until I know the threat is over.
Now answer my question. What do you want?
We're investigating the death of a friend who was murdered recently. The trail led to a member of the Herd of Al-Jidi.
You consort with the Herd? Why then you are my enemies, and the shop's ward should have prevented you from entering.
Wait, no. The Herd are no friends of ours.
Is that so? Well, whether or not that's true, I fail to see what any of this has to do with me.
A reporter named Rex Murphy pointed us to here and suggested you might have more information about them. What's more, our late friend Professor Tillingist mentioned you in her notes.
Tillingist? You're friends of Wilhelmina Tillingist?
Yes. Just recently in Arkham, we...
And you say she's dead. You actually saw her corpse?
Yes, that's why we're...
Oh, no. No. It's gone much further than I imagined. No wonder they're after me.
What's gone further? Who is after you?
Why, the Herd, of course. They're behind all of this. Quickly, there's no time to waste.
What is this sputtering fool talking about? And the way he keeps interrupting you, how rude.
Wait, just a moment.
Engelbert, he's my assistant. I sent him to infiltrate the Herd and learn what designs they might have on me. If Tillingist is dead, I fear he might be next. I don't dare leave the protections of my shop. You must find him and bring him back here. Take two right turns after leaving my shop. His house is the one with the red door, just past the cafe.
This is all too much. I bet he's just sending you on a wild goose chase to get rid of you.
There's the red door. This must be Engelbert's house.
Well, the door's ajar. Someone must have left in a hurry. We better take a look inside.
This must be Lenry's assistant, Engelbert.
It's the right address, all right.
When will this trail of tragedy end? My death was only the beginning.
The body's fresh. The killer can't be far away.
Say what you will about Lenry, he was right about there being an assassin. We should find the killer before he gets to Lenry, and our answers.
Be careful, friends. One who goes hunting for a tiger may learn that the tiger finds him first.
We should search this place first. Maybe Engelbert or his killer left a clue behind.
Now we have you, assassin.
I don't know what you mean.
You can't fool us. We know who you are, and you won't get away.
What's wrong with you? I didn't even look at you sideways.
Oh dear, what a blunder.
But he looked like... Oh, maybe we were a little too quick to act.
Let's think a little harder about what we know next time.
Now we have you, assassin.
I don't know what you mean.
You can't fool us. We know who you are, and you won't get away.
Thank you. failed my mission, and the herd, and the great...
What good luck you have, my friends, to overcome such a deadly foe.
With the assassin out of the way, it's time to get back to La Nuit. He's bound to help us now.
If you expect gratitude from that one, I'm afraid you'll be sorely disappointed.
What's this notebook sticking out of the killer's pocket? Here's something about getting rid of Linuit. Wait, there's something about Professor Tillingus, too. Escort Tillingus to the witch house in the bayou. I wonder what they wanted with her there.
Why have you come back without Engelbert? Don't tell me something has happened to him.
We were too late to save him, but we found the assassin and dealt with her.
I told you. You didn't believe me, but it was true. I suppose I should thank you, even if you did fail to save poor dear Engelbert.
We found a note he'd hidden in his apartment. It said something about you and a portal in the bayou.
As I suspected. Alas, Engelbert, you served me well up until the day of your death.
What are you talking about?
The so-called comet that passed near the Earth a few weeks ago, that was not a comet at all. Do I surprise you? I dare say I do by the look of wonder and astonishment in your eyes. I am no mere purveyor of voodoo trinkets and curios, but a scholar of occult knowledge. My ancestors knew the truth, and they passed it down to me along with forbidden tomes and arcane scrolls. We know the danger of the herd of Al-Jidi. They are behind all of these events, and they have been scheming so for decades. Why, just 20 years ago,
hold on a minute. Let's back up to not a comet at all.
Of course. To the uninitiated, this can seem overwhelming. Very well. The disturbance astronomers mistook for a ball of dust and ice orbiting the sun was in truth a portal. A gate leading to the star Deneb al-Gedi, which the more astute you may recognize as appearing in the constellation known as the Tail of the Goat, dozens of light years away.
A gateway to a distant star? Go on, pull the other one, Linuit.
I did warn you Lanui was unstable. What some mistake for eccentricity is full-blown madness, I tell you.
Not impossible. Just hidden from the knowledge of most. You do know that occult means hidden, don't you? Well, I suppose I must keep things as simple as possible for you. Or perhaps not. You have seen the proof yourselves in the book entitled Culte des Ghouls. You've witnessed the manner of deaths of those who posed an obstacle.
It seems impossible, but it must be true.
For a long time, I suspected Tillingus was allied with the herd. She was studying the comet, after all. But with her death, it seems they weren't allies after all. If I had realized, I would have done more to warn her.
Don't beat yourself up about it, Linuit. There'll be time for that after we've dealt with this herd.
Engelbert infiltrated their cult. He told me of their general plans and described their headquarters in the bayou. The locals call it the Witch House, and are afraid to go near it. From what Engelbert reported, I knew they were approaching favorable time for their schemes.
Why do you even listen to this madman? He says he knew I was in danger, but failed to warn me. He sacrificed his own assistant rather than risk his own skin. Untrustworthy villain.
And now you think this portal has opened?
It has. It must have. I know the method of closing it, but the danger of going there... No, I would never survive the attempt.
You're safe with us. After all, we've already saved you from one assassin.
That's true. And I suppose it's no fault of yours you were too late to save Engelbert. Very well, I agree.
Then that is our plan. We'll go together into the bayou.
Closing this mystical gate is far beyond this charlatan's power. You'll only be putting yourselves in more danger than you've ever faced before. This is much too much. The bayou is a treacherous place in and of itself. How much worse must it be if this portal truly exists? But of course it doesn't. Even if a door to another world could exist, why would it be in a swamp? And how could you close it with a magic book? Oh, my friends, think about what horrors this portal unleashes. Even considering the dangers you've survived so far, it's far too perilous to approach that gaping maw in the earth. There'll be no escape this time.
Very well. Here we are in this vexatious bayou. You may soon regret your decision, and not only because of the noisome vapors.
This part of the bayou is so unnatural, it must mean the portal is close.
You shouldn't be here, my friends. Something tells me it's very dangerous.
Indeed, it must be. I will go ahead and begin my preparations.
Don't get any bright ideas about slipping away.
One may slip in unobserved, while many are sure to be detected. Besides, I've never heard such a commotion as you tramping through the bayou. I doubt we've left a single twig unsnapped between here and New Orleans.
Now listen, Lenui.
No, you listen for once. The corberry is native to this particular region of the bayou, and corberry branches act as an accelerant to the sort of invocations I must conduct to close the portal. Now, gathering some for me would be far more useful than proclaiming my arrival with all the fanfare of a marching band. Three branches should prove sufficient.
All right.
Oh, and look here. Our friends the Herd have redecorated the bayou. I wouldn't have imagined you could make this foul style any less appealing, but those grotesque statues have certainly done the trick. At least they provide obvious waystones to the portal. Follow them when you're ready to join me. And don't forget the coral berry branches.
Why you persist in doing this man's bidding is beyond... He could turn against you at the slightest whim, I'm sure of it. You had better remain on your guard.
There are purple berries on this plant. I bet it's the coral berry bush let me describe.
Let's take some. You said it would help with the ritual.
Isn't that the same creature we saw at the university and in the Herd's mansion?
It looks the same.
And dangerous, I bet. Let's be careful.
The trees here look strange.
Portal must be changing the plant life. We must be close.
Just look at these marvels. Can you doubt for a moment that you're facing something far greater than yourself?
Shooting all the way out here.
Must be the herd.
What are they shooting at? We should take a look.
One of those little horrors just ripped open the fisherman. It looks like he's been fighting them for days.
I warned you, friends. Coming here was a terrible mistake.
Beware, that thing could be lurking nearby.
Look out! Behind us!
Those tentacles! It's almost like the monster in the asylum. Maybe it's a variation of it.
That's the fisherman's body under all those tentacles. Those little beasts must transform!
No time for that. Defend yourselves!
I'm pleased to see you didn't become lost in the bayou. It was only after you stomped off that I realized I should have tied a string to you.
I'll be glad to leave this place.
Nevertheless, we're almost done. Did you retrieve some coreberry branches?
No, I'm afraid we didn't.
Alas, I had hoped they would facilitate the ritual. While your failure is as I awaited your return, I ransacked the belongings the herd abandoned.
A map of New Orleans.
There's a big circle around Jackson Square.
The herd must have plans for something happening there.
That's all very well for you, but let us focus on closing this portal first.
Must be the portal. Never seen anything like it.
What a marvelous phenomenon. Just think of all the alien beings that emerge from the mind reeled.
This place is unsettling. We'd better do what we came to do and get out of here. Whenever you're ready, La Nuit.
As I cannot defend myself while preparing the ritual, I trust you will see that those loathsome creatures do not interrupt me. After all, you were the ones who wanted to come here.
Something's coming, La Nuit. You're out of time. Get started!
Not this beast again.
If only you had listened to me instead of that insult.
Keep it away from La Nuit.
I thought that was some monster the herd conjured, but they're taking orders from it.
Thank you.
You've done it. You've closed the portal. I hope you're pleased with yourself, having deprived science of the greatest phenomenon humans have ever discovered.
Nenri's down. The effort of closing the portal must have used the last of his strength.
If Lanhui can close this portal, he can surely open it again. Can you afford to let him live?
He made good on his promise. Let's help him up.
We're done. Let's get out of here.
You do as you must, but we must now part ways. Comet surely fragmented upon entering Earth's atmosphere. Pieces of it may have fallen in other locations. I must learn whether any of them also created portals.
Do you think that's likely?
I cannot know until I visit the other sites, but we mustn't take the chance. Good luck with the other tasks. I now have one of my own.
Seriously believe these rumors of a witch living in the bayou, can you? No doubt there's nothing there but an old, abandoned, and empty house. What are you doing? There's nothing of interest between these dilapidated walls, I assure you.
Well, it certainly has the right atmosphere for a so-called witch house. This place is horrible in every way. What's that monstrous smell?
Still don't know what this place has to do with Professor Tillinghast.
Maybe not. But we've seen enough clues pointing here. And those creatures seem to appear whenever the professor is involved.
Brace yourselves. Something's coming this way.
Is crawling with monsters.
Did you hear that? There's something bigger than those creatures in here.
Whatever it is, the sound is coming from upstairs. Coincidence. This looks just like Professor Tillinghast's nursery. The hole in the wall seems to lead outside.
Could the creatures be getting in this way?
Probably so. We should find a way to close the hole. There must be a hammer and nail somewhere in here. Who would draw a door on the wall?
There's a noise from the other side. If someone can get away just by drawing a door on the wall, my job just got a lot harder.
There's a note here. I've sealed my experiment inside. If you need to reach the office, take the other passage. W.
W. For which?
There's a key on the note. I bet it unlocks the second passage.
Let's hope that office holds some answers.
Thank you.
Lux in obscuro, sumus. Where have we seen that before?
It's the Miskatonic University motto, isn't it?
Right. Light in the darkness. That can't be just a coincidence.
We could use a little more light in here.
We saw a lighter and a candle earlier.
Considering the weird puzzles we've encountered, I wouldn't be surprised if there were more to it, like arranging the candles in a pattern.
What happened?
Perhaps we lit the wrong candle. That's one more candle.
Did you hear something?
I think so. It came from another room. Maybe the one with the writing on the wall.
Let's take a look.
As much as I appreciate the gothic consistency of sliding bookcases and hidden stairs, I tremble to imagine where those steps lead.
There's only one way to find out.
Thank you. Someone's been here recently.
Considering it's behind a secret door, there must be something important in here.
How nosy you are. Always poking into others' belongings. Have you no respect for privacy?
Oh, Wilhelmina. What caused you to become involved in such an evil scheme?
She was working with the Herd of Algidi all along. They wanted to open a portal and summon some otherworldly being.
At long last, you know the truth. But, as with everything that has occurred, only because I led you to it.
How could you do this, Professor?
You saw those marvelous creatures. They are living beings beyond the wildest dreams of Darwin. Where is your scientific curiosity? We owe it to science, to the world, to learn more about these previously unknown species.
We have to stop her.
It's far too late for that. My plan has been proceeding for so long you can't possibly halt its momentum.
That note from Tillinger said something about experiments. Shouldn't we find a way through that weird door?
Human experiments? This is monstrous.
This door has to lead to the same room we saw earlier. Shall we take a look?
We'd better check it, just in case.
If I never see one of those abominations, it'll be too soon.
Kidnapped, enslaved, and then turned into this... this thing. And then to die here, all alone.
We have to put an end to this madness.
Thank you.
So, this marvel was the culmination of my experiments. I can't say I'm surprised.
Professor Tilling has created these monsters herself. But why did she have to experiment on humans?
No matter the reason, we must stop the herd of Al-Jidi.
Oh, my dear friends, it's far too late. Even though the map directs you to Jackson Square, you can't possibly halt my herd's plans. You are powerless against us. Did you imagine my herd would stand idle while you wandered the bayou? Such overconfidence will prove your undoing. The ranks of my herd swell with new devotees thanks to the conversion of these poor souls. Soon you shall join them.
Look at all this carnage. We were too late to prevent it.
My herd has performed most admirably. She will be pleased with us.
We must stop them. Let's head toward Jackson Square. Cut off from Jackson Square, and those police need help.
Get out of here, you!
If you need a hand, the Bureau is happy to help.
It's too dangerous for civilians. Besides, that damn Charles never showed up with the fresh rounds. You wanna help? Find Officer Charles and make sure he gets us that ammo.
We'll do our best.
Don't waste your time helping those police officers. They'll be dead soon.
Keep your heads down.
That strange chant is coming from Jackson Square.
I feel strange. That chant is affecting our minds somehow.
We're not the only ones it's affecting. We'd better hurry.
Those tentacle monstrosities. No wonder it's such chaos here.
That was the point, after all.
There's a dead police officer. Could it be Charles?
Better get these shells back to the boys in blue.
You are far too obliging, especially to a group of doomed police.
What's the matter?
My husband and I ran from out of our house, but in all the panic, I lost track of him. Those creatures must have cut off his escape. Won't you please help him?
Don't worry, young lady. Your husband has a higher purpose to serve now, or soon shall.
We'll do what we can.
Voices. I hear voices echoing inside my head.
So do I. Ignore them.
It's getting worse. Let's hurry.
Thank you.
That must be the woman's husband.
Still alive? He must be very slippery.
He's surrounded. Let's help him.
Creatures are dead. You're safe now.
Oh. One of those creatures got inside me. I don't know what to do.
Still conscious. He must be unusually resistant. If only I had the appropriate facilities and a living body to study him during the transformation.
He's turning into one of those creatures, isn't he?
Too late for him. We need to finish him off.
What?
Sorry, mister. It's for the best.
At least we should tell his wife he didn't make it.
people are acting crazy. In fact, they're acting just like the asylum inmates.
Voices are changing them.
Hurry!
There was nothing we could do for him.
Let's make sure it doesn't happen to us. Remember him? Poor devil didn't make it.
You had your chance to help him. Too.
Even if you could defeat us, you would achieve nothing!
How does that goat-faced horror even talk?
Taking control of this little city is but a tiny fraction of our preparation for her arrival.
What are you talking about? Who is her?
You pawns began this journey thinking she was dead. But soon she will become the gate. All shall be born from her mansion in Arkham. The dark young shall rise.
It's talking about Professor Tillingist.
Is he saying she's alive after all?
Ia Shub-Niggurath.
We need to get back to Arkham.
You're already too late.
We have to finish here first. We can't abandon these people.
Down for the count, I think.
The police can look after the survivors. Let's go back to Arkham.
After such a long and twisted journey, it's time for a homecoming. Come, my friend. Let us end where we began, in my Arkham mansion.
Welcome home, my dear friends.
I didn't like what we found here the first time, and I have a bad feeling we'll like it less this second go-round.
Let's find Professor Tillingus and stop her.
Yes, please come and join me. Together we shall marvel at the gifts of Shub-Niggurath.
We should make sure we're prepared before we head into the house. Not another one of those monsters.
Not just another one. This one is different. This one is the Professor herself.
There you are at last. Yes, I am quite different from those ordinary reborn. I am her chosen, her nearest worshipper. Soon you will join me in her adulation. Soon you will understand her cosmic grandeur, and together we will sing Ea, Ea, Shub-Niggurath.
That abomination!
Is that thing Professor Tillingus?
At last, my promised maternity is nigh. Behold my transcendent child, and become free. Yeah, yeah, Shub-Niggurath.
What has she become? It's unspeakable!
Thank you. sorry. What began as scientific curiosity became obsession. That obsession led to madness. And the madness consumed me. The things I have done, I know they are unforgivable. You did the right thing, my friends. Please do what you must to ensure no one ever follows my unspeakable example. Arkham is safe, but at what price?